My compadre Rivero Sainz is missing. So if we bow our heads and give a 1 minute silent prayer for what was going to be a great compadre that we all missed today, and that perhaps during the program we shed some tears. 1 minute, please. And also a co-teacher, and of course my comadre Rosa. And they did a great job. Then they turned him loose and sent him to school, to kindergarten, and to junior high, and to high school, where he was president of the student council and participated in many other activities. And he has shown all of us quite a thing. It is very easy to talk, and it is very easy to dream. I can set goals, and you can set goals, and we can talk about it, and we can dream about it. It's very easy. All of us can do that. But the thing that is difficult is the commitment. And this doctor made that great commitment. Sometimes working in two jobs, sometimes stopping for a semester and getting straightened out again. But sometimes getting sick, it was difficult. But he showed us the definition of commitment. And for the young people here, that is a great thing to know. It's a great thing to know this this young man that all of us love so much. And I hope, I'm a teacher, and I mentioned certain people, their mistakes and their great things. And commitment is the number one. Commitment is the number one. During this last month, as he finished and they told him you did it, I noticed a great change on him. His smile was different. His drinking beer was different. Before, it was a bundle of nerves. He was getting everybody's nerves also, especially his wife. So, but lately he's gained weight, and his eyes have gotten into focus. So he got away from that stress and he began to realize what's going on. I've worried only about one thing. You know they're moving to Walla Walla, Washington. And I'm afraid they just might like it over there. And that would make it a little difficult for the family that's in our culture, we're so close, and we don't want to open our wings so our young ones will fly away and leave. It's a rough thing. But we're very grateful to the teachers we had on behalf of Rene, and to his mother and father that we miss so much. Rene will never be able to say thank you to his mother. It's going to be a lifetime commitment. Because it takes a lifetime to thank your parents. And Rene is that type of a fellow, so we don't have to worry about that part. Of course, his other partner, his wife, Rhonda, she was there and worked hard for him and stayed out of the way many times and leave him alone many times. And she also was under stress. So, I want to ask Rhonda to speak. I want to ask Rhonda to speak in a little while. But the last time we met was in 1990, and we mentioned a few things. We were there. They broke into Rhonda's car that night, and that was part of our celebration. They sold her radio and broke her window at 6th Street. That's the name of the street. Rene was chasing guys all over the place. Anybody that looks suspicious, he went after him. Rhonda would yell, "Oh, stop!" And that was part of it. And if you can notice, there's been a change in Rhonda since 1990 to now. And Rene already has plans for that offspring. That offspring is going to be a dentist about 25 years from now. So, besides his family, he had great friends in college. Roommates were great. We're missing one of them, David Carrillo, who was also at the end of a doctorship. And Bobby was his friend, roommate, and we're going to ask Bobby to say a few words because he knows Bobby during those hard years at Texas University where many people were partying and celebrating, and Bobby and Vinny were right there keeping their books open. So that was part of growing up. Local things, Marisa, Randall's roommate. And there were great friends, and great friends is what helps you. Great friends and good health. And we were asking for that. So.
And the show is in. So, I haven't had that. That's why I'm getting a little nervous. But. All I want to say is, first of all, congratulations to my brother. I mean, any member of the family can attest to the fact of, you know, what it was like growing up in the kind of conditions he did, and then to be what I consider now a success, to accomplish what he did. I think it's a great achievement. I think it's something to really look back and say, wow, anybody who would have been raised in the kind of conditions that we were, with solid foundations, I thank my mother, and of course I can't go on without saying about my father, who I miss so much, because I know that he wanted to be here, and I'm sure that he is here. And that's probably the only sad part about this whole encounter, or this whole meeting with everybody. What I am very happy to see is that I'm getting to see the family unite. I'd like to see more of that, because life's too short to not have a family unity. For you young folks out there, I hope that this was something, especially for the folks in Ramirez, that it is something for you young kids to look at and think, maybe, hey, one day I'm going to be there. And that's what I really want the message to be out there for the young folks. As far as everybody's concerned, like I said, friends, relatives, we shared a lot. Rennie and I shared a lot of things, you know. We roomed together, we fought together, we couldn't stand each other, you know, to a certain degree. But, I mean, that's part of growing up. I mean, we never let go. We're always communicating with each other. I hope now that he becomes a doctor, his telephone bill to my house is a little bit. And I always seem to be the guy that's always calling him. He never calls me, and neither does Rhonda, so... But I can remember all of those things, and one of the things that I was even mentioning to Derek and to Eddie and Mom who were in the car, we always said when Rennie was young, he was so ambitious when he was a little, what I call squirt back then. We kept saying, everybody's going like, who are you going to be and what are you going to do? And they came to Rennie and he said, I'm going to be a dentist. I can remember that one day when everybody went, yeah, right. Well, I mean, I can't believe that happened, and it's a realization right now. So, I mean, I got to pinch myself and say, is this really true? Did it really happen? Is that a drink? Wait till I get a toothache, is right. But, I mean... I'm really happy. I'm very proud of him, just like I am of all my family members, because, again, we always didn't have the money. We didn't have the cars in high school. We didn't have a whole lot. But I tell you one thing we did have, and that I can say about my parents, is that we had that foundation that kept us as a family unity. And to this day, I will strongly advocate that if you have problems within your families or whatever, I mean, life's too short. We need to unite. We need to help each other, because that's what we're about. Because if you as a family member can't help each other, then you can't help anybody. And I'm so proud, like I said. This is a very happy occasion for me. I wouldn't have missed it for the world. And I just wish him the best of luck. And I know he'll be good in his profession. Rhonda will be a good wife, and in her profession the same way. And his children hopefully will have the same foundation that we were able to share. But I think I'm getting the guardale thing. Is that this one? It's this one. I don't know what that one means. So, I mean, I remember, going up to UT when Bobby was there and Rene, they were rooming together and they had never knew what Jungle Punch was. They introduced me to Jungle Punch. Ever since then, I like margaritas. But, I mean, that's all I want to say. I'm very proud of him and I am about my brothers and sisters and my mom and my dad and everybody else I have. If I can be of help to anybody, I will most certainly do that. So, okay?
Yeah. Usually it's the only one I think that has their age, and I'd like to do a little song. Hey, you love you. I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. You made me want to do it. I want to tell you. I guess you always knew it. You
sing it, Mama.
Make me glad. But there were times, dear.
Hoover Dam parking lot, the most expensive parking lot built in the USA. There's Mom and Dad.
Just park next to these here.
Thank you. open-minded.
Right.